Good morning, dear children. You are welcome back to online class of English grammar. We are studying the chapter the pronoun. In the previous class, you studied what is a pronoun, and we also studied the personal pronouns in detail. Pronoun is the word which replaces a noun or which is used instead of noun. Today we will discuss its second type, that is the reflexive pronoun. What is a reflexive pronoun? We must know what is reflexive pronoun and how to use it. We use a reflexive pronoun when the subject and the object in a sentence are the same person or thing. Dear children, you know every sentence is having a subject and there is an object in a sentence, object of the verb or object of the preposition. When in a sentence the subject and object are the same person, in that case we use the reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun points back to the doer of an action. Doer of an action, one who is performing the action in a sentence, means the subject. So, dear children, this means that the doer of the action is also the receiver of the action. Doer is performing the action as well as he is receiving that action. The action does not pass from one person or thing to another person or thing, but it reflects back to the same person or thing. For example, the example is Mansi blamed herself for this loss. Mansi blamed herself for this loss. Can you recognize the subject in this sentence? Yes, Mansi is the subject. Mansi is the doer of an action. Action is action of blaming. Clear? Blamed is a verb. So the action of blaming is performed by Mansi. So Mansi is the doer of an action. And the object is herself. Clear? Object is herself. This is Mansi is the subject. Herself is the object. And here in this sentence, you can see, dear children, the subject and the object is the same person. Mansi blamed herself. The action started, action is performed by Mansi and also is received by Mansi. So, the performer and receiver of the action is the same person in this sentence. So, the pronoun herself is reflexive pronoun. Now let's see in the next example. He always talks to himself when he is alone. The subject is he. He is the subject. He always talks. Action of talking. Action of talking is performed by the subject he. So he is the doer of an action. He always talks to himself. Himself is the object. Here we can see the subject and the object in this sentence are the same person. Subject and object is the same person. So in that case also himself is the reflexive pronoun. Now, dear children, always remember in reflexive pronoun, the subject and the object are the same person. Now, look at the table given on the board. How do we form the reflexive pronouns? Reflexive pronouns are formed with the help of personal pronouns by adding the suffix self or selves. We add self for singular form and selves for plural form. Here you can see in this table the personal pronouns are given this side and the reflexive forms are given this side. I, myself. We, ourselves. We means it indicates plural number. So selves we use. Ourselves. You, yourself. When we use the, we know that the pronoun you can be used for singular and plural both. When we use it for singular number, we write only self, yourself. When we use the pronoun you for plural, we write yourselves. Now, the next is pronoun he. Its reflexive form is himself. She, herself. It, itself. They, themselves. So all these pronouns are the reflexive pronouns. Here the table which is given on the board is the list of reflexive pronouns. And we use them when the action comes back to the person or thing who does it. Somebody performs the action in the sentence. When the same action comes back to the doer of an action. Clear? Receiver of that action is the doer itself. Means in a simple way, subject and the object are the same person. In an abstract sense, in an easy way to understand, we can say that it is like a mirror effect. When you stand in front of the mirror, what you can see? Your own reflection in that mirror. You do not see something else. If you are in front of the mirror, you will see yourself. You will see your own reflection in that. In this case, grammatically, you are doing the action to yourself, not someone else. The action is reflected back to you. Action, whoever is the performer of the action, is the receiver of the action. So, understand it. In reflexive pronouns, the subject and the doer of an action is a same person. Now, dear children, if we talk about emphasizing pronouns, emphasizing pronouns are also the same pronouns, no difference at all. So, it's little confusing for the students to recognize what is emphasizing pronoun and what is reflexive pronouns. Dear children, though the words are same, but their functions are different in the sentences. Clear? Let us try to understand emphasizing pronouns, and also we'll discuss about the difference between the reflexive pronouns and emphasizing pronouns. What is emphasizing pronoun? Emphasizing pronoun is used to emphasize who does the action in a sentence. It put focus on the person who is performing the action. For example, if we say John did his homework himself, as I said that emphasizing pronouns put focus on the person who has done that action. Clear? It emphasizes, it is used to emphasize who does the action in a particular sentence. John did his homework himself. John did his homework himself. John has done his homework by himself. Nobody else helped him. Action of doing the homework is performed by John himself. Clear? Now, you can see here, we are emphasizing the fact that he was the person who did the homework, not somebody else. In this sentence, John is the person who performed the action of doing the homework, nobody else. Clear? Now, if we say we completed the project ourselves, if I say another example, we completed the project ourselves means the action of completing the project is done by ourselves, not somebody else. Clear? Now you are clearly seen, you have clearly seen the difference between the emphasizing pronouns and reflexive pronouns. Again, we'll talk about that. With an emphasizing pronouns, the action goes from the subject to the object. Clear? But the object is not the same person or thing as the subject. This is the difference, dear children. Now, for studying the difference between emphasizing, why we get confused in reflexive pronouns and emphasizing pronouns? Because the words are same. Emphasizing pronouns are also myself, ourselves, yourself, yourselves, himself, herself, itself, themselves. The same words are used as reflexive pronoun and emphasizing pronoun. So it is very important to learn about the difference between both the pronouns, how to recognize them. Now I'll write two sentences on the board which will help you to recognize. Now let us discuss about the difference between emphasizing pronoun versus reflexive pronoun. Here in this sentence, John is the subject and verb is did. John did what? His homework. Homework is the object. John is the subject. Dear children, first thing we can see that here the word himself is emphasizing that the doer, performer, all alone has done his work. John has done his work by himself, all alone he has done, not somebody else. Secondly, to find out the difference between them, I'm telling you. Here, the John is the subject, homework is the object. In this sentence, Mansi is the subject, herself is the object. Mansi blamed whom? Mansi blamed herself. So, herself is the object. Now, the easiest thing to recognize the difference in emphasizing pronoun. If the pronoun is emphasizing, the subject and the object are not the same person or thing. Hey John and homework, both are completely different. Clear? The action performed by the subject is not received by the object, means both the persons are not same. The doer of an action and receiver of an action are not the same person or thing. But in this sentence you can see Mansi blamed herself. Mansi is the subject, herself is an object, is the same person. This is the way to recognize whether the pronoun is emphasizing pronoun or reflexive pronoun. If it is self or self's form, you should know it is reflexive or emphasizing pronoun. And then you should know their role, how they play in a sentence. After that, you can say, yes, in this sentence, himself is emphasizing pronoun and here herself is reflexive pronoun. Dear children, sometimes we put the word by, B-Y, by, before an emphasizing pronoun to give the meaning of alone. For example, if I say, I cooked the meal by myself, I cooked the meal by myself. This means that I cooked the meal all alone and without any help from anybody. I cooked the meal by myself means I cooked it all alone without taking help from anybody. I did it on my own. Nobody else helped me. So, if I say she drew the picture by herself, it means she herself drew that picture without taking help from someone. So, when we add the word by before the emphasizing pronoun, it means the doer has done that work all alone without taking help. Usually children get confused in emphasizing pronoun without by and with by. Let's see these two examples. I painted the wall myself. I painted the wall. I is the subject. The wall is the object. So here we can see the subject and object are different. So myself is an emphasizing pronoun. First thing, it is emphasizing, it is putting focus that I myself has done. Secondly, we to find out the difference between reflexive and this emphasizing pronoun, we have studied that if subject and object are different, means it is emphasizing pronoun. If subject and object are the same person, it is reflexive pronoun. This is one way to recognize. Here in this sentence, we can see it is used without word by. I painted the wall myself. Clear? Another sentence is I painted the wall by myself. By myself means the wall painting is done all alone by myself. I have done it all alone without taking help from anyone. I have painted the wall myself means I have done this work, but maybe somebody helped me in that. I did not call any painter from out, but still maybe my friend or someone helped me in that process. Clear? But by myself means all alone. The work is done all alone by the doer of an action. So at last, again I will tell you, dear children, how to recognize whether the pronoun is emphasizing or reflexive pronoun. Though the words are same, reflexive forms and emphasizing forms both are completely same, but their functions are different. So the easiest way to tell the difference between the two is to identify whether or not the subject or the object are the same person or thing. Whether the subject or object are the same person. If subject and object are the same person, it means it is reflexive pronoun. If subject and object are the different persons or things, it is emphasizing pronoun. Now, I hope these both the pronouns, reflexive and emphasizing pronouns, are clear to you. Keep on practicing, dear children, and understand it nicely. Thank you.